Hey everybody, Dr. Cranky here in the laboratory. Welcome to another Cranky show. We are going to show you, without getting too messy here, we're going to show you how we assemble and glue our wheels, our tires, our wide wall inserts, okay, our disc brakes, which have been subtly pitted. Using the method described previously in the two clinics I shared with you recently, and it's you know, I'm not gonna actually do it. I'm just gonna show you how utterly easy it is. We use this kind of extreme power 5-minute epoxy, which come in these handy bottles. All you have to do is you just make sure that you have equal gobs. You put it on a piece of paper, of course. One of the beauties of this resin is that, as you can see, it's already, it's 5 minutes. You could get them in different time settings. I like the 5 minutes because that usually gives me plenty of time. I use a toothpick, and you can see that I recycle my toothpicks. This was a toothpick that I was using to hold the engine of this build. And while it was being painted, of course. So basically, you know, you get all your components and the wide walls are inserts, which is the beauty of this. I've already scuffed the wheels with sandpaper. And so this is the backing right here. This is the back of the hubcap. And so you insert it, you make sure that it's all centered and perfect. You know, and so it requires this little pin, right? This is the mounting pin. Putting it in often will get the wheel insert to come out, the back of the wheel insert. So again, you have to go around and make sure that it's perfect, okay? And that the alignment is straight. All right, so now this is what you're going to do. You're going to mix up your resin, okay? Just like I said, a drop at a time, a little bit at a time goes a long ways. Then you are going to seal in the, let me get my handy pointer. You are going to seal in the pin, right in there, and put a nice, healthy gob or dollop of the resin right there. Okay, then you're gonna get your wheel cap and just make sure that it's, again, the same way that you did the back, that it's nice and centered, okay? And then you just basically, you know, turn it upside down and let it dry. All right, these have all been done already, so, and it's pretty sturdy, okay? Then when you go assemble, put the wheel actually in the running, to make a rolling chassis, you just make sure that you put a little bit more glue on there. This time it doesn't have to be resin. It could be basically, model glue, even though, you've got a metal piece there. Or you could, again, come back to the five-minute, two-part resin and add just a little bit, okay? Or you could do glossy accents, anything that's going to hold it, and then you just frame it, you square it up, and that's it. You know, it'll be on there, and it's as easy as can be. And just take your time, go slow, be methodic, and you will have wheels and tires and a rolling chassis that will be pretty darn sturdy, squared up. All the wheels will be touching, and you've done it all with a two-part resin, which is great. And then that's it. I usually leave the paper and the resin and the toothpick so that I know exactly when the 5 minutes are up, and when it's rock solid, you know it's done. So anyway, just a little mini clinic on there to show you how we do these wheels and tires. All right, my friends, stay tuned in for more Cranky Show coming right up.